Hey everyone, I'm Scott from HostGator, and in this episode of Hosted, we'll cover the top 6 easiest and most accessible ways to speed up load times for your website. Number 1, optimize your images. If you're like me, you have thousands of photos that are mostly duplicates and mostly duck lip selfies. Well, if you want to share those photos on your website, there are 2 simple things you can do to make sure your website stays fast and crisp. Simple thing number 1! If you're using a CMS like WordPress, you probably know that there are options to upload full-size images and adjust the way the images are displayed. Neat bar trick, maybe, if you're at a bar for web builder noobs and nobody is impressed by your actual super impressive close-up magic.
Whoa!
Seems cool when you're 8, but handling images like that actually takes up more server space and adds extra steps for your backend, which slows down your website load times. The better option is to use an image tool like Preview on Mac, Microsoft Paint on Windows, also super cool when you're 8, or Photoshop, to resize your images to the actual display size you will need. Load times decrease, stress level of your overworked server also decrease. Everyone's happy. Simple thing number 2, once your image is the right size, compress it. This is an image of me in compression shorts, actually. Mike, do you like that?
Cute.
You like the compression shorts? You think they're lame? Well, I think they're tight.
I'll give you that one.
Come on, man. Come on.
That was good.
Okay. I should mention that if you compress your images too much, you will start to lose image quality and things become harder to see, which is the opposite of overly compressed compression shorts. Things become easier. Easier to see. See, in this image, you can see right here in the image. That's blurred out. Image compression can also be done using Preview, Paint, or Photoshop by exporting as a lower quality JPEG. Or you can use a tool like ImageResizer.com. With smaller size files, think how many more duplicated selfies you can take.
Yay.
Number 2, clean house on your WordPress plugins. If you're using WordPress, this can be a tremendous help. Marie Kondo that shit. If a plugin doesn't bring you joy, take a picture of it and throw it away. Over the course of building your website, you may have installed a bunch of plugins for various reasons, taking up too much space and slowing things down, but maybe you aren't using all of them anymore. Or maybe there are other versions out there that do the same thing at a fraction of the server real estate and processor power. Get them out of here. Get him out of here. Get off my lawn, plugins. Go through your plugins and delete or uninstall the ones you don't need. To check and see if there's a particular culprit slowing things down, turn them off one at a time and run your site through a performance tool like gtmetrics.com. With this method, you'll be able to isolate potential threats to your load times. After cleaning up your plugins, you can relax a bit. Let yourself unplug. Yeah. Perfect reaction. You want a cheese, right? Me get out of here? I don't want to go. Number 3, update your site scripts. I remember when I lived in Hollywood, you'd always see a bunch of like wannabe screenwriters sitting at laptops at Starbucks. Like, what do you think, bro? You're not going to make it.
Scott, it's not that kind of script.
Many developers of common CMSs, e-commerce platforms, or plugins regularly update their code for updated releases. When they do, you need to update your site scripts too. This will make sure your site is running on the fastest, most up-to-datest code possible. In WordPress, this can be done by smashing that update button. We also recommend doing this about once a month and making a backup of your site beforehand just in case. Keeping your site scripts up to date also helps patch any holes that may become security or hacking threats. And if you're curious, I do have a great idea for a script where the host of a web hosting internet show makes it big in Hollywood as a screenplay writer.
Hey!
Yeah, maybe? Okay. Well, DM me, I'll send you the script. After I update it, of course. Okay. Number 4, use CDNs. CDNs, or content delivery networks, are vast networks of servers housed around the world. If you're not using a CDN, your site likely loads from your hosting server's central location. This might slow things down if your visitors live far away, or if they don't have that floppy CDN organizer under their passenger seat in their 92 Corolla hatchback.
Hi-oh!
It's a CD reference?
No,
it's a CD joke?
I love a good CD.
Is it funny? Yeah. You know what I'm talking about, the little floppy things?
Pretty seedy joke.
It is. Good one, Mike.
Hey. Nasty.
Using a CDN also helps prevent your site from crashing if your server gets overloaded by requests. If you are using a CDN, users will be accessing a cached version of your site from the CDN host closest to them. To get started, look into services like SiteLock TrueSpeed, StackPath, or Cloudflare. all of which were also names of girls on my roller derby team.
That was a real laugh that time. I think I got him.
I love roller derby.
Number 5, enable browser caching. Browser caching allows a visitor's browser to store copies of your site's individual pages, so when they keep returning to your awesome site, the content can be called up from their cache rather than reloading the entire page. Makes load times way faster. Cash money, baby. In WordPress, you can add plugins like WP Supercache to handle this for you, or get a web developer to integrate browser caching into your server-side scripting. Whichever way you go, as they say, a site loaded with cache is a site owner loaded with cash.
Hey.
Hey.
And finally, 6, organize your CSS and JavaScript. JavaScript, screenplay written at a coffee shop. As in my screenplay.
Hey.
JavaScript, also snippets of code that should be kept to the bottom of an HTML page. If you have any raw HTML elements, organizing your code with CSS at the top and JavaScript at the bottom will prevent progressive rendering, saving visitors' browsers precious resources that would otherwise be used to load and redraw elements of your page and prevent your page from waiting on full execution before loading.
Ooh! Yeah!
Too much jargon, maybe too much jargon. Bottom line, it's a lot faster. And there you have it. 6 very easy and accessible ways to speed up load times for your website. 53% of mobile users will abandon a website that takes longer than 3 seconds to load. Slow load times will have your visitors leaving your site faster than it takes a writing agent's assistant to hang up on me. In our next episode, top 5 ways to make it in Hollywood, taken from a real expert.
Yes!
Thanks for watching. Let us know how these strategies work out for you in the comments, or let us know your screenplay ideas. Totally won't steal them. I might steal them. Thanks for watching. Bye! Compression shorts? You gonna get a pair of compression shorts?
Probably not.
No? I thought you got, don't you have a pair of compression shorts?
Mike, your thighs will look great in compression shorts.
Yeah, that's
fine. Mike?
Can I just dry the shorts? Can I just dry, like, shorts I already own? Like, overdry them?
Just shrink them? You want to shrink the normal shorts?
What happens if you dry compression shorts?
They get bigger.
Oh.
Yeah.
You need a pair of compression shorts.
Yeah. You get compression shorts. You get compression shorts. You get compression shorts. And your websites will load faster.